Hi, my name is Arya, and welcome to my series on how to do well on the AP Computer Science A Free Response. So in this video, we're going to be going over question 2 of the 2017 Computer Science A test. So this problem is a little different than the one you encountered before. The other one was a bit more about your algorithmic skills, how you can use loops to traverse over numbers or over array lists, but this one is a lot more about your class designing skills, and it will really test how good you are at turning abstract ideas into code via objects. So let's read over the problem. This question involves the design of a class that will be used to produce practice problems. And so they give us an interface with two methods, getProblem and nextProblem. And if you remember with interfaces, if you implement an interface, you have to implement those methods. So we're probably gonna have to be implementing these methods. And so it then goes on to describe multipractice. The multipractice class is a study practice that produces multiplication practice problems. A multipractice object is constructed with two integer values, first integer and initial second integer. The first integer is a value that remains constant and is used as the first integer in every practice problem. So let's just write that down. We're gonna want a first integer that's constant. The initial second integer is used as the starting point for the second integer in the practice problems. The second value is incremented for each additional practice problem that is produced by the class. So let's write that down. And now they're going to give an example. For example, a multipractice object created with a call new multipractice 7,3 would be used to create the practice problems 7x3, 7x4, 7x5, and so on. In the multipractice class, the getProblem method returns a string in the format of first integer times second integer. The nextProblem method updates the state of the multipractice object to represent the next practice problem. So basically, we're going to have these two ints, and when we call getProblem, it's going to say first int times second int. And when we call nextProblem, it's going to increment that second integer so that next time that we call getProblem, we're going to get the new problem. And so now it's going to show us a few more examples that you can look through, but they all seem pretty self-explanatory. You call it with 7,3, you get the problem, you call next problem, and call get problem again, it's going to be 7x4, and then you call it again, it's going to be 7x5, and 7x6. In this example, they call it with 4,12, and they immediately call next problem, and so when they call get problem, it's immediately 4x13. And if they call getProblem again, it's again 4x13, because they didn't call nextProblem. So basically we know getProblem isn't going to modify any variables, it's just going to print, and nextProblem is going to just modify variables, but it's not going to do any printing. So that's what we can glean from these examples. And so at this point, with all of this information, I encourage you to please pause the video, try to implement this class as best as you can, and then when you have reached this ending point, come back to this video and see how I'm going to implement it. Alright, so the first thing you always want to do when you're creating a new class is think about what variables you're going to need to keep track of. And in this case, I pretty much already told you, you're going to need the first int, which keeps track of the first number, and the second int, which keeps track of the second number, which can be added onto. So let's write that down again. And when we're actually writing the code, we may want to just use shorter names just so it's easier to write and our hands don't hurt as much. So the next thing that we're going to do is plot out the methods, and whenever we're making these classes, it's very important to keep track of the signatures. So thankfully we're implementing this interface, so we know we're going to want getProblem, which returns a string, and nextProblem, which doesn't return anything. So let's write that down. So getProblem, where just going to want to return that string, so first int, you know, plus the space and times, and then add second int. And then for next problem, to get the next problem, we're just going to want to add one to the second int, so it's going to be as easy as All right, so now that we have kind of the outline for what our class is going to look like, let's start implementing it. So the first thing to remember when making a new class is what the signature should look like, and it's especially important here because we're implementing the interface study practice. So we're going to want to type public class multpractice implements study practice. And so at the top here, we're going to want to keep track of our variables, and we're going to make these variables private because we don't want them to be able to be modified anywhere outside of this class. So private int first int and private int second int. And the next thing we're going to want to do for any class, of course, is write the constructor. And this should be pretty obvious. So we're going to do public alt practice, and we're going to want to take two ints, so int a, int b. And we're going to want to say first int equals a, and second int equals b. And that's that, that's the constructor, because we're just storing the variables to the correct places. And so let's work on the next method, which is going to be getProblem. So that's going to be public, and it's going to return a string, getProblem. And this takes no parameters. And so all we're gonna do is return first int plus times and then plus second int. And that should return the problem. Very simple. And now we're gonna write the next problem code. So public, and this is void because it does not return anything, it just adds to the second int. And so this is also going to be very simple. We're just going to want to add one to the second int. So you can do second int plus plus. And that should be good. Let's go over one of the examples just to make sure this will do what we want it to do. So for this first one, we create a new multpractice, 7,3. So it's going to store 7 into first int and 3 into second int. And then we call getProblem, and it's going to return first int 7 times 3, perfect. And then it calls next problem, which is going to add 1 to second int, so now it's going to be 7 and 4. And if we call getProblem again, it's going to be 7 times 4. And so this looks good. As you can see with these class problems, if you organize them correctly from the beginning, actually implementing them will be a piece of cake. And so now let's see how this question would be graded by the AP graders. So remember that this question, it was just one part, so it's going to be worth a lot of points, so you should spend the full about 20 minutes on this problem. So the first point comes from the header. So the first is you're going to want to have the right header, public class multpractice implement study practice, which is what we have, and there's no partial credit here, so you either get that one right or you don't. The second, you have to declare all necessary private instance variables, which we do. We only need two, the first int and the second int. For the next 2 points, they're from the constructor. You have to first declare the header, which is public multpractice and then two ints. So we have that point. Initializes all instance variables using parameters. So it's going to initialize this one using the parameter and then this one using the parameter. So the next 3 points come from getProblem. So the first point's just from the header. So public string getProblem, we have that. The second is building the string with the current values, which we do here, first int, times, and second int. And then finally, it has to return that string. So we have that all on one line. Finally, you get 2 points for the next problem. First, you just have to declare the header, public void next problem. And then the second point comes from updating the instance variable by 1, basically. So we do that right there. If you had trouble with the method headers, remember that when you're implementing an interface, they basically need to have the same name and return type as the interface you're implementing. So in this case, for study practice, we needed one that was a string getProblem and one that was void nextProblem. And these are going to be public because you're going to have to call them outside of the class. Some things to note is for these points, if you forgot to have the word public for either the header or for the constructor, that's fine, you're still going to get the point. You just can't declare them as private. Another thing to note is that if in the get problem method you mess up the capitalization or the spacing, it does not matter. They do not care about small things like that, and you will still get the full points for that. But please check out the scoring guidelines to see any more specifics, or leave a comment below and ask how I would grade your answer. I hope this was helpful to you, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.